Okay, so we have Pilipili Technical Code, no? Chapter 1, Definition and Terms, and Chapter 2, Overview. Yan. So first, natin yung mga definition of terms. So that is Article 1.1 of the Pilipili Technical Code. So itong una is yung ukol sa mga accessible. So when we have accessible as applied to equipment, so it is admitting close approach not guarded by locked doors, elevation, or other effective means. So ibig sabihin nito, if it is accessible na applied natin sa equipment, so hindi siya guarded by any permanent locked doors o di kaya ay nasa mataas na lugar, example elevation, and other effective means. Tapos pag accessible as applied to wiring methods, so it is capable of being removed or exposed without damaging the building structure or finish or not permanently closed in by the structure or finish of the building. Example, this one is exposed wiring. Kasi yung exposed wiring, pwede po nating tanggalin yung ating wiring without damaging the building. Then, accessible readily as applied to equipment or wiring methods. So, yung pinaka-general term niya. So, capable of being reached quickly for operation, renewal, or inspections without requiring those to whom ready access is requisite to climb over or remove obstacles or to resort to portable ladders and so forth. So, ibig sabihin, readily accessible. So, it can be accessible. Madali siyang puntahan, madali siyang kunin without any aid of special ladder. No? Kung dito nakalagay to climb, no? That is ladder, or kailangan mong tanggalin, no? Yung any obstacle or to resort to any means para or using any other equipment para makuha mo yung equipment na yon or matanggal mo yung mga wirings. Yan. So, yan yung tatlong types ng accessible when it comes to the Philippine Electrical Code definition of terms. No? Next, we have a group of words naman which all have their similarities because they are all units in amperes, but they have different definition. Unahin natin yung ampacity. No? So, the ampacity is the current in amperes that a conductor can carry continuously under the conditions of use without exceeding its temperature rating. So what does it mean? So when you say ampacity, yan yung kayang dalhin ng ating wires, no, the current na kayang dalhin ng ating wires na hindi lalagpas sa kayang temperature rating. For example, 90 degrees Celsius ang ating THHN, tapos number that number ba 2.0 square mm, tapos 16 amperes. So at 90 degrees Celsius, 16 amperes ang kanyang kayang dalhin. So in case na tumaas yung temperature, no? So ang mangyayari diyan is magiinit yung wire, tataas yung resistance, so bababa yung kanyang current rating. So when we say ampacity, yan yung kanyang current rating at its temperature level, no? So yan yung ampacity, the maximum current in amperes at a conductor na kaya niyang dalhin without exceeding, na hindi siya nagiinit, no, without exceeding its temperature rating. Next is overcurrent. So overcurrent is any current in excess of the rated current of equipment or the ampacity of a conductor. It may result from overload, short circuit, or ground fault. So overcurrent is a fault current. So ibig sabihin ng overcurrent, mas mataas ang kanyang current, no, o sobra siya sa current na sa kanyang rating. For example, equipment is rated at 30 amperes tapos nagkaroon ng short circuit, therefore tataas yung kanyang yung current na papasok sa ating sa ating equipment or yung current na mismo na sa ating equipment. So magiging kilo amperes yan, no, kasi short circuit or overload, no? Overload, no? So yan yung tawag doon is overcurrent, no? The overload, short circuit, and ground fault current are also known as overcurrent. Then overload itself is the operation of equipment in excess of normal full load rating or of a conductor in excess of a rated ampacity that when it persists for a sufficient length of time would cause damage or dangerous overheating. A fault such as a short circuit or ground fault is not an overload. So ang overload according to the Philippine Ethical Code, that is an equipment is operating, so siya ay gumagana na excess sa kanyang normal full load rating. For example, a motor is rated at 20 amperes full load. Tapos, during its operation, no, there is some kind of trouble. Kunyari, nag-lock rotor siya. So, tumaas from 20 amperes naging 120 amperes. No? So, that that 120 amperes now is an overload, no? So yung overload, if it is persist, no, through a certain amount of time, pwede siyang mag-cause ng damage sa ating equipment or could be causing dangerous overheating. Kapag nag-dangerous overheating, then it can cause short circuit, it can also cause fire. But note that according to the Philippine Electrical Code, yung ating overload is different from a short circuit and a ground fault, no? Yung short circuit kasi we have two current carrying wires, no? Two current carrying wires or a neutral conductor na nagpang-abot, that is a short circuit. When you see ground fault naman, as we later define later, yung ground fault is there is a path, no? Path from our system to the metal parts of our electrical system, no? So may mga part dun sa ating yung may mga metal parts sa ating system na naging daanan ng current, which is not good because it can cause electrical shock. Then you have interrupting rating. So the highest current as rated voltage that a device is intended to interrupt under standard test conditions. So this is the rating that is used for breakers. So when you say interrupting current, yan yung kayang current na i-interrupt ng ating devices before it will fail. For example, we have a breaker 6 kaik, no? 6 kaik is kaik means kilo ampere interrupting capacity. For example, that breaker is 6 kaik. So if the short circuit occurs at 10 kaik, yung breaker natin is masisira. No, because ang kaya lang niyang i-interrupt is up to 6 kaik, no? And if lalagpas siya 6 kaik, that will now be considered to be as the above, no, above its level. Kaya if we have a certain coordination, no, yung sa breaker natin, pag we are going to coordinate our breaker with regards to its interrupting rating or interrupting capacity, so mas mahalaga na i-consider yung kaik. Of course, as RME, so hindi naman yun masyadong critical sa inyong part because you are just interpreting what is planned, no? Ang kadalasang diyan gumagawa ng coordination when it comes to the protection of the breakers are the PEE, no? And sometimes also the REE, no? So, interrupting rating, yan yung kayang i-interrupt na current ng ating overcurrent devices, no? Okay? Then we have another batch of definitions. So we have appliances. So appliances is utilization equipment generally other than industrial that is normally built in standard size or types and is installed connected as a unit to perform one or more functions such as clothes, washing, air conditioning, food mixing, deep frying, and so forth. So with this definition, masasabi natin that appliances is a domestic utilization equipment. So what does it mean? So those are utilization equipment, yung load natin na ginagamit natin sa ating bahay to perform domestic tasks, no, like washing clothes, giving heat and ventilation to our house, food mixing, deep frying, and so forth. So they are called appliances or appliance. Then cooking unit, counter-mounted. So it is a cooking appliance designed for mounting in or on a counter and consisting of one or more heating elements, internal wiring, and built-in mountable control. So what does it mean when you say cooking units? Yung ating mga stove, they are also as cooking unit counter-mounted kasi nakalagay siya sa ating countertop, no? Then device, it is a unit of an electrical system that is intended to carry or control but not utilize electrical energy. So ang device hindi siya considered as a utilization equipment kasi from that definition itself hindi siya gumagamit ng electrical energy. Its only main purpose is to carry or to control the flow of current in our circuit. So example, switch, our resistors, no, our breakers, our disconnecting means, so those are considered as device. Then electrical sign. So electrical sign is a fixed, stationary, or portable, self-contained, electrically illuminated utilization equipment with words or symbols designed to convey information or attract attention. So meaning these are what we called as the yung mga ano natin, yung nasa mga yung nasa bandang EDSA, no, yung mga tawag doon, yung mga billboards, no. So the billboards is considered as an electrical sign as long as it is electrically illuminated, no, gumagamit siya ng kuryente to illuminate so that the purpose of that electricity is to light something para maka-attract ng attention or makapagbigay ng information, so that is considered as an electric sign. So ang equipment naman, it is a general term including material, fittings, devices, appliances, luminaires, apparatus, and the like used as a part or of in connection with an electrical installation. So equipment ginagamit natin to perform any task in electrical installation. For example, yung ating grinder, the drill, no? So they are considered as electrical equipment, including also the devices, the switch, the cut-out fuse, the disconnecting means, so they are considered as electrical equipment. Then explosion-proof apparatus, so apparatus enclosed in a case that is capable of withstanding an explosion of a specified gas or vapor that may occur within it and of preventing the ignition of a specified gas or vapor surrounding the enclosure by sparks, no? So flashes or explosion of the gas or vapor within and that operates at such an external temperature that a surrounding flammable atmosphere will not be ignited. So ano yung ibig sabihin nito? We have a certain apparatus na in case there is a spark inside the apparatus, hindi siya makukos for the flammable gases na nasa labas ng ating apparatus or ng ating enclosure to also ignite. No? So we must say explosion proof na kukontain niya doon sa loob ang kanyang spark, ang kanyang fault. So yan yung ibig sabihin ng explosion proof apparatus. So they are usually installed in hazardous locations. Yan. Okay. Yan. Next we have utilization equipment, no? So katulad ng sa definition sa RA 7920, utilization equipment is any equipment that utilizes electrical energy. So yun yung sa RA 7920, but dito it is talagang in-specify that the usage of electrical energy is for electronic. So electronic circuits, no, like TVs, you got yung mga cellphones, no? Electromechanical, no, like motors, generators, no, the transformers, chemical, heating, lighting, or similar purposes. So that is the definition for utilization equipment. Next, Ascarel, no? So this is one of those hard to remember na mga definitions sa Philippine Electrical Code. But we will define that one as a generic term for a group of non-flammable synthetic chlorinated hydrocarbons used as electrical insulating media. So ascarels of various compositional types are used under arcing condition. The gases produced while consisting predominantly of non-combustible hydrogen chloride can include varying amounts of combustible gases depending on the ascarel type. So the ascarel is commonly used for a electrical insulating media, no? Bakit ito yung ginagamit? Because they are non-flammable synthetic chlorinated hydrocarbons. So meaning hindi sila nagliliyab. So that is an ascarel. So they are group of different materials. So based depending on the type of the ascarel, so merong iba na it could have self-contained combustible gases, so depending on the type of the ascarel, but their generic purpose or their generic characteristics is that they are non-flammable, hindi sa nagliliyab, synthetic, so they are man-made and chlorinated hydrocarbons, no, that is ascarel. Then volatile flammable liquid. So it is a flammable liquid having a flash point below 38 degrees Celsius, or a flammable liquid whose temperature is above its flash point, or class 2 combustible liquid that has a vapor pressure not exceeding 276 kilopascals at 38 degrees Celsius and whose temperature is above its flash point. So meaning volatile flammable liquid is a type of liquid that is easily ignited o madali siyang magliyab. So it has its flash point, no, yung point na nagliliyab siya at below 38 degrees Celsius, which is usually the room temperature. Or if there is a certain pressure applied to that type of liquid, no, vapor pressure, naging vapor siya, tapos there is a certain pressure. So kapag lumagpas siya ng 276 kilopascal, it will also ignite. So that is volatile flammable liquid na madaling magliyab. Okay? So attachment plug, plug cap or plug, a device that by insertion in a receptacle establishes a connection between the conductors of the attached flexible cord and the conductors connected permanently to the receptacle. So yung ating plug, no? So yan yung attachment plug. The correct term for that is attachment plug. So it,
It provides a connection between our receptacle conductor at yung ating flexible cord na nasa ating appliances. So that is what we called as attachment plug. Disconnecting means, so it is any device or group of device or other means by which the conductor of a circuit can be disconnected from their source or supply. So any other way na yung ma-disconnect natin yung ating source or supply. So an example of disconnecting means is a switch. We could also have a transfer switch. We could also have our breaker, no, our main safety switch or our knife switch. Yan. Outlet, no? Outlet is a point on the wiring system at which current is taken to supply utilization equipment. So, ang outlet pala is just a location. So, a location on your electrical system na kung saan pwede mong lagyan ng ano ng contact device, no, that the proper term for that contact device is a receptacle na kung saan pwede mo nang makuha, no, yung electrical energy na nang doon sa ating outlet. So, kaya yung pinakaiba ng ano, outlet. No, outlet is a location. Yung ating nilalagay sa outlet, ang tawag natin is receptacle. So, receptacle is a contact device installed at the outlet for the connection of an attachment plug. A single receptacle is a single contact device with no other contact device on the same yoke. So, that is what we called as a one-gang receptacle. Isang contact device sa isang location ng ano, sa isang location na ng outlet, no? But if you have a multiple receptacle, so it is two or more contact device on the same yoke. So yan yung mga two-gang, three-gang natin. So the standard is just three-gang. If lumagpas ka na ng three-gang, then that will not be considered as a permanent receptacle but an extension, no? Extension receptacle or an extension wire, no? So for example, if we have an outlet, no, if we have a plate tapos may tatlo diyan, so ibig sabihin in a single ano in a single outlet there are multiple receptacles. So yung isang outlet na yun nilalagyan na tawag natin is yoke. Yan yung yoke. So if there is three or two or more, so we have a three gang outlet, no, three gang receptacle on a single yoke. Then receptacle outlet, an outlet where one or more receptacles are installed. So we say receptacle outlet, so doon nakalagay yung ating receptacle. For example, we have a convenience outlet. So that location now, that outlet now is what we call as a receptacle outlet kasi may nakalagay doon na receptacle. Yan. No, kasi pwede din naman we don't put a receptacle on an outlet. Pwede rin we will put a breaker, no? Breaker. So that is a breaker type na ano na outlet, no? Kasi may breaker na nakalagay doon. Okay? Then we have power outlet. So power outlet is an enclosed assembly that may include receptacles, circuit breakers, fuse switch, and buses. What are meters mounting means intended to supply and control power to mobile homes, recreational vehicles, park trailers, or boats, or to serve as means for distributing power required to operate mobile or temporarily installed equipment. So when you say power outlet, this is an assembly na kung saan nakalagay doon yung kailangan natin to supply power to a certain wiring system. So may nakalagay doon ng receptacle, may mga circuit breakers, holders, and also the metering means. Yan yung power outlet. Then you have lighting outlet. So an outlet intended for direct connection of a lamp holder or a luminaire, so lighting fixture, or a pendant cord terminating in a lamp holder. So lighting outlet natin is naka-connect siya directly to a lamp holder. So that is a lighting outlet. Iba yan sa receptacle outlet na yung naka-connect directly is a receptacle. Okay, luminaire. A luminaire is a complete lighting unit consisting of a lamp or lamps together with the parts designed to distribute the light, to position and to protect the lamps and ballast. So where applicable, and to connect the lamps to the power supply. So it is a complete assembly na meron ng ballast if yung ating light is gumagamit na ballast with also the reflectors and the starters, no? So yan yung luminaire. So it is a complete lighting system unit. And next, authority having jurisdiction or EHG. So the organization, office, or individual responsible for approving the equipment, materials, and installation or a procedure. So yung EHG, so for example, that is the OBO. So it is a agency na kung saan, kung hindi siya klaro sa Philippine Electrical Code, so they will be the one to approve, no, any equipment or any materials na pwedeng gamiton because this equipment or materials is found to be following the code. Yan. Then electrical practitioner license, so licensed practitioner, so one who has undergone training in electrical engineering and has complied with the requirements of the Republic Act 7920 or otherwise known as the new electrical engineering law. So if you are a licensed electrical practitioner, so may proper training ka with regards to electrical, tapos nakapasa ka ng exam as stipulated or nakalagay doon sa ating RA 7920 or the Electrical Engineering Law. So if you are an RME, nakapasa ka ng written board exam. If you are an REE, nakapasa ka ng written board exam. If you are a PEE, nakapasa ka ng technical, no, technical interview sa board. Okay? Next, we have Electrical Practitioner 9 license, so meaning walang lisensya. An electrical practitioner that has not complied with the requirements of RA 7920, but they are considered as qualified persons with relevant education and experience to enable him or her to perceive risk and to avoid hazard which electricity can create. So they are qualified to install electrical system, but they are not licensed kasi hindi sila nakapasa ng board. So if that's the case, ano dapat yung gagawin ng non-licensed in case meron siyang i-install? So yung non-licensed dapat always under supervision siya ng licensed electrical practitioner. Okay? Next, we have automatic, no? So the type of controlling on our system. So automatic. So when we say automatic, so that is a self-acting, self-directing, or self-operating by its own mechanism when actuated by some impersonal influence, as for example, change in current, pressure, temperature, or mechanical configuration. When we say automatic, yung ating device is not needing human intervention in order to change its condition either off or on. So that's what we mean as automatic. Pag non-automatic naman, so it will require personal intervention, no, to operate, no. So we call that one as a manual control. Yeah. Then we have remote control circuit. Any circuit that controls any other circuit through a relay or an equivalent device. So such a circuit that will operate, no, by controlling any other circuit into an equivalent device, no. Then you have signaling circuit, any circuit that energizes signaling equipment. So kahit ano circuit that will energize signaling equipment. Then a controller, a device or group of device that serves to govern in some predetermined manner the electrical power delivered to the apparatus to which it is connected. Tapos yung ating MCC or motor control center, an assembly of one or more enclosed section having a common power bus and presumably principally containing motor control units. So yung motor control center, dyan yung nakalagay yung ating mga motor controllers. Okay? Next, we have the different parts of a building and the definition of a building itself. So we have bathroom. So this is an area including a basin with one or more of the following: a toilet, a tub, or a shower. So building, so a structure that stands alone or that is cut off from the adjoining structure by firewalls with all openings therein protected by approved fire doors. So a building that is as a separate vertical structure na kung saan pwede either that is used for commercial, residential, or industrial purposes. Yung bathroom naman is an area inside a building or inside a dwelling unit na kung saan mayroong toilet, no? Kahit alin dito ang mayroon, ang importante mayroon siyang lababo, tapos may toilet, yung ating bowl, may bathtub or may shower. It will be considered as a bathroom. Garage. So a garage is a building or a portion of a building in which one or more self-propelled vehicles can be kept for use, sale, storage, rental, repair, exhibition, or demonstration purposes. So for example, if we have a showroom of a Toyota, no? The showroom of a Toyota is considered to be a garage kasi nandoon yung ating sasakyan for sale and exhibition purposes. So that is a garage, no? Yung sa bahay nyo may garahe, so that is a garage. Parking area will be considered as a garage kasi pwede nating it will be used kung saan nakakept, no, yung ating sasakyan for storage, no. Yan. Hoistway. So any shopway, hatchway, well hole, or other vertical opening on space in which an elevator or dumbwaiter is designed to operate. Yung dadaanan ng ating elevator, no? Yung mismong knockout o yung mismong space na kung saan dadaan yung elevator, that is what we called as hoistway. Then we have guest room. So a guest room is an accommodation combining living, sleeping, sanitary, and storage facilities within a compartment. Yung guest suit naman is considered to be like a house, no? Na may sariling room but have a common rooms for a certain necessity, no? So a combination of one or two more contiguous room comprising a compartment with or without doors between such rooms that provides living, sleeping, sanitary, and storage facilities. So group of a guest room, which is a guest suite. Plenum is a compartment or chamber to which one or more air ducts are connected and that form a part of the air distribution system. So yung plenum is a compartment or a chamber na kasama sa ating air ducts, ating ventilation system, no? That will form a part of the ventilation system of a building. No, yan yung plenum. Then bonding, no? So bonding is the permanent joining of metallic parts to form an electrically conductive path that ensures electrical continuity and the capacity to conduct safely any current likely to be imposed. So that is the joining of any metallic part of a system, no? So yan yung bonding, either through wires, either through welding techniques. So that is what we called as bonding. So it will create bonding. The main purpose of bonding is to form or to create an electrically conductive path. Tapos yung bonding jumper. So yung bonding jumper natin is a reliable conductor to ensure the required electrical conductivity between, no, between metal parts required will be electrically connected, no. So ang bonding conductor is a bonding jumper is a conductor na ginagamit natin to have our two or more metal parts to be bonded together. Yan, no. Then we have bonding jumper equipment. The connection between two or more portions of the equipment, grounding conductor, no? So that is the connection, no, between the equipment and the equipment grounding conductor. Then bonding jumper means the connection between the grounded circuit conductor and the equipment grounding conductor at the service. So yung connection ng ating ano, ng ating grounded circuit conductor, yung galing sa ating circuit, tapos yung mismong grounding ng ating ano, ng ating system, no, na nasa main natin, no? So that is bonding jumper main. So bonding jumper system, the connection between the grounded circuit conductor, the equipment system grounding conductor at a separately derived system. So in case we have a separately derived system, so the connection between the grounded circuit conductor and the grounding conductor of the derived system, so that is system bonding jumper. Yan, system bonding jumper. Then we have ground. So ground is a conducting connection, whether intentional or accidental, between an electrical circuit or equipment and the earth to some conducting body that serves in place of earth. So ano ba sabihin ng ground? So pwede siyang intentional, so sinadya natin na magkaroon ng connection, or accidental, so that will be called as ground fault. So it is connection between our equipment to the earth or any other conducting body in replace with earth. For example, sa barko, wala namang lupa sa dagat. So what we consider as earth in a boat is yung kanyang hull. Grounded, no? Grounded. Connected to earth or to some conducting body that serves in place of earth, no? So ibig sabihin ng grounded, nakakonect na siya sa ating ground or sa earth. Grounded effectively or effectively grounded. Intentionally connected to earth through a ground connection or connections of sufficiently low impedance and having sufficient current carrying capacity to prevent the build-up of voltage that may result in undue hazard to connected equipment or to person. So we will say effectively grounded, talagang muna tayong nilagay ng mga wires, no? Ng mga system na may low impedance. So example, that is a wires or a bare copper wire. That is to ensure that there is a low impedance connection from the system to the ground. Na in case there is a ano, there is a tawag doon, sudden build up of voltage or overcurrent, no, because of ground fault or natamaan ng kidlat yung ating system, so the current will not go to our equipment. So the bulk of the current, no, yung overcurrent na ano doon, is hindi pupunta sa equipment na maaaring mag-cause ng sira, or if in case we touch any metal parts during a ground fault or during a lightning, hindi tayo makukuryente. So that is what we called as effectively grounded. Kasi meron tayong tamang path na kung saan doon talaga siya pupunta lahat ng mga overcurrent or mga ground fault current or mga light, yung mga current or surge current na galing sa lightning papunta sa earth, no? So that is what we called as effectively grounded yung ating system. So solidly grounded, so connected to ground without inserting any resistor or impedance device. So if we say solidly ground, wires lang talaga ang ginamit natin for grounded, automatically connected into our grounding electrode. Then ground fault circuit interrupter, a device intended, no, for the protection of personnel that functions to de-energize a circuit or portion thereof within established period of time when a current to ground exceeds the values established for a Class A device. So ground fault circuit interrupter, so yung device na protect sa atin in case there is a ground fault, so siya yung nagtitrip. So when we see Class A device, that is 6 milliamperes ang kanyang sensitivity. Okay, ground fault protection of equipment, so a system intended to provide protection of equipment from damaging line to ground fault currents, no? So kapag nalagyan natin ng ground fault protection ng ating equipment, so it will protect from the ground fault currents that may cause damage to our equipment. So yung ground fault will only detect the ground fault, no, kung may ground fault. But in short circuit or overload, dapat maglalagay din tayo ng another protection for short circuit and overload. So usually that will be our breaker. Okay, grounding conductor. So a conductor used to connect equipment or the grounded circuit of a wiring system to ground or grounding electrodes or electrodes. So yun yung ano, conductor na ginagamit natin to create a effectively grounded path, so which is connected to our grounding electrode. So equipment grounding conductor, sa the conductor used to connect the non-current carrying metal parts of the equipment, raceway and other enclosures to the system grounded conductor. The grounding electrode conductor of both at the service equipment at the source or a separately derived system. So this is the conductor that we are going to use to connect our equipment to the system grounded conductor or to the electrode, no? Yan. Grounding electrode, a device that establish an connection to the earth. So yan yung ating nililibing, no? Buried in our earth, that is our grounding electrode. So grounding electrode conductor, so that is the conductor used to connect the grounding electrodes to the equipment grounding conductor. Yung grounding conductors for our equipment, so ang i-connect diyan is the grounding electrode conductor. And the grounding electrode conductor is now connected to our grounding electrode. So mga ano to siya, mga parts ng ating buong grounding system. Then identified as applied to equipment, so recognizable as suitable for the specific purpose, function, use, environment, application, and so forth, were described in a particular code requirement. So ibig sabihin ng identified, it is applicable to be used, no, in its purpose, no, na nagfa-follow sa standard ng Philippine Electrical Code. Inside from or within sight from or within sight. So where this code specifies that one equipment shall be in sight from or within sight from or within sight and so forth of another equipment, the specified equipment is to be visible and not more than 15 meters. So kapag sinabing in sight from, dapat hindi lalagpas ng 15 meters ang kanyang distance. So sinabi sa code, in sight from, within sight from or within the sight, so that is 15 meters below ang distance ng ating equipment or ng ating or ng ating mga devices, no? Okay? Then branch circuit, so the circuit conductors between the final overcurrent device protecting the circuit and the outlets, no? So yung ating yung ating part ng ating panel, no? Yeah, na pinoprotektahan ng ating mga branch breakers. So ang tawag doon sa circuit na yon is a branch circuit. Okay? So branch circuit appliance or appliance branch circuit, a branch circuit that supplies energy to one or more outlets to which appliances are to be connected and that has no permanently connected luminaires or lighting fixtures that are not part of an appliance. So an appliance branch circuit is wala nakakonik na lighting system o wala nakakonik na bulb. Meron sigurong bulb yung mga lead ng ating appliances, no? That is the exception. Pero when you say appliance branch circuit, walang nakakonik na mga appliance. No, walang nakakonik na mga lighting, okay? Or lights. Next, we have general purpose branch circuit. A branch circuit that supplies two or more receptacles or outlets for lighting and appliances. So general purpose, so halo-halo. Merong para sa appliance, merong para sa lighting na mga outlet na nakakonek sa same na branch circuit. And that branch circuit is what we called as a general purpose branch circuit. Okay? Then branch circuit individual, so that is an individual branch circuit yung ibang tawag natin. No? And branch circuit that supplies only one utility equipment. For example, the branch circuit for our air conditioning unit. No? Isang breaker, isang load. So that is individual branch circuit. Multi-wire branch circuit, so a branch circuit that consists of two or more ungrounded conductors that have a voltage between them and a grounded conductors that has equal voltage between them, between it and each grounded conductors of a circuit and that is connected to the neutral or grounded conductors of the system. So ibig sabihin ito, our branch circuit has multiple ungrounded conductors and common neutral. No? So that is what we called as multi-wire branch circuit. Enclosed. So when we say enclosed, surrounded by a case, housing, fence, or walls to prevent person from accidentally contacting the energized part. So enclosed. So talagang hindi mo mahahawakan yung mga life parts. Guarded, covered, shielded, fins, or enclosed, or otherwise protected by means of suitable covers, casing, barriers, rail, screens, or platforms to remove likelihood of approach or contact by a person or objects to a point of danger. So sabi ng enclosed, meron siyang case or housing or fencing na pwedeng mag-prevent. No? Pwedeng mag-prevent para hindi mahawakan yung energized parts. Pag guarded, so talagang covered siya, shielded, fins, at enclosed pa na wala talagang chance na pwedeng mahawakan yung energized parts. So dito kasi sa enclosed, there is a likelihood. Pag dito naman tayo sa guarded, remove na yung ating likelihood to approach or to put persons in danger dahil sa energized parts. Enclosure, so the case or housing or apparatus or the fins or walls surrounding an installation to prevent personnel from accidentally contacting energized parts or to protect the equipment from physical damage. So enclosure is used to enclose our devices or our system, no? To prevent accidental contact, no? Of persons. Energized, electrically connected to a source or voltage. So may supply na, that is what we called as energized. Cabinet, an enclosure that is designed for either surface mounting or flush mounting and is provided with a frame, mat, or trim in which a swinging door or doors are or can be hung. No? So yung cabinet natin, enclosure siya designed for surface or flush mounting and is provided with a frame, no, mat, or trim in which swinging door, no, pwede tinagyan ng doors, or pwede din siyang ihang. So that is a cabinet. Ang cut-out box naman is an enclosure designed for surface mounting that has swinging doors or cover secured directly to until scoping with the walls or box properly. So itong cut-out box is only surface mounting. Habang yung cabinet could be surface or flush mounting. Dead front without live parts exposed to a person on the operating side of the equipment. So yung mga breaker, yung mga panel board natin may dead front yan. Yung paunang cover sa ating breaker, the purpose of that is to prevent accidental contact nung front facing sa ating breaker. Okay? Then you have panel board. So panel board is a single panel or group of panel units designed for assembly in the form of single panel, including buses and automatic overcurrent device, and equipped or without switch for the control and light, heat or power circuits designed to be placed in cabinet or cut-out box placed in against a wall partition or other support and accessible only from the front. So yung panel board natin, it is only accessible from the front. So this is used to house our protective devices or overcurrent devices. Metal enclosed power switchgear, a switchgear assembly completely enclosed on all sides and top with sheet metal except for ventilating openings, no, yung may mga breather siya for the ventilation, containing primary power circuit, switching and interrupting device or both with bases and connection. The assembly may include control and auxiliary device. Access to the interior or the enclosure is provided by doors, removable covers or both. So yung ating metal enclosed power switchgear, no? So the difference of that with the panel board is yung ating metal yung ating switchgear is aside from it is used to contain the primary, yung mga ano natin, yung mga medium to high current natin na mga devices, no? It is also have the capability to be removed, no, or to access by removing its cover, its top, or using the doors. Yan, yan yung metal enclosed power switch gear. Exposed to as applied to live parts, so capable of being inadvertently touched or approached near than a safe distance by a person. It is applied to the parts that are not suitably grounded, isolated, or insulated. So when you say exposed, so pwede mo siyang mahawakan kasi kulang siya ng guarding or hindi siya na-isolate or wala siyang insulation. So that is to live parts. If to wiring method naman, on or attached to the surface or behind panels designed to allow access. So yung naka-ano lang, nakikita mo lang yung wiring, no? Or nakikita mo lang siya for AC access. No? So yan yung exposed as applied to wiring method. Dust tight, no? So the different types naman tayo ng enclosure, protection. Okay. So we have dust tight constructed so that dust will not enter the enclosing case under specified test conditions. So hindi napapasukan yung ating enclosure ng dust. So that is dust tight. Rainproof constructed, protected or treated so as to prevent rain from interfering with the successful operation of the apparatus under specified test condition. So in case na umulan, hindi nagkakaroon ng tripping or hindi nagkakaroon ng trouble yung ating equipment na nasa loob ng enclosure na rainproof. Yan yung rainproof na enclosure or rainproof na box. When you say raintight naman, constructed or to protect so that exposure to a beating rain, no, yung medyo malakas-lakas na ano na ulan, will not result in the entrance of water under specified test condition. So when we say raintight, raintight, kapag masyadong malakas na yung ulan, hindi pa rin talaga nagkakaroon ng ano, ng tawag doon, ng pagkakaantala, no? Hindi nagkakaroon ng interference, no, sa ating sa equipment na nasa loob ng ating raintight na enclosure. Yung rainproof kasi, no, the difference between rainproof and raintight, yung rainproof is pwedeng may bubong lang yung ating enclosure. Kapag raintight naman, so lahat ng mga knockout doon is meron siyang gasket. That is to prevent the enter of rainwater. Kapag watertight naman, constructed so that moisture will not enter the enclosure under specified condition. Hindi nakakapasok yung moisture. So mas mataas to na level compared to raintight. Yung raintight kasi is ano lang, 'di ba? Yung ulan parang tulo lang 'yan. When we say moisture, even if there is a sudden change in temperature or humidity, hindi talaga nakakapasok yung water, yung moisture sa ating watertight. So pwede mo siyang ilublob sa tubig, walang makakapasok na tubig. Yung raintight, kapag nilublob mo sa tubig at a certain time, napapasukan siya. No? Because hindi naman constant yung flow when it comes to raintight or beating rain. No? Hindi yan parang tubig na talagang nandun lahat, no? Nandun yung tubig. Yung raintight kasi o yung rain kasi is beating lang, no? Hindi siya constant na mayroong tubig. Yung rainproof naman is you are only protecting na mayroong part doon na hindi talaga papasukan ng tubig. But if the rain will be mas malakas na, so hindi na siya pwede yung rainproof. Weatherproof is constructed for climate, no? So that the exposure to the weather will not interfere. So hindi siya na apektuhan ng init, ng ulan, so that what we called as
weatherproof.
Okay, live parts. So, conductor or conductive part intended to be energized in normal use. So, any conductive part na pwede nating gamitin for to energize our system, no? So, that is live parts. So, intended to energize, no? May dumadaan na kuryente, yan yung live parts. Then we have location, no? Dump, no? Dump location is location with protected from weather and not subject to saturation with water or other liquids but subject to moderate degrees of moisture. So mabasa-basa siya pero yung kanyang basa is hindi galing sa tubig na nakapasok sa ating ano, sa ating location, but only through the humidity, no? Dry is not normally subject to dampness or wetness. So talagang dry, no? Dry location. A location classified as dry may be temporarily subject to dampness or wetness in the case of building under construction. So if the building is under construction, so nakakaroon talaga kasi wala pa naman tayong waterproofing at fireproofing, so nakakaroon talaga ng chance na yung mga locations na dry, for example, the bedroom must be a dry location, so nakakaroon talaga ng chance na magbasa kasi hindi pa naka-install yung properly yung mga bintana. No? Example naman ng damp locations are the canopies, no? So for the damp location, canopies, marquees, roof, open porches, like unlike locations, interior locations subject to moderate degrees of moisture such as basement, barns, and cold storage water warehouse. Kapag wet naman, from the word itself, basa, no? Installation underground or in concrete slabs, masonry, or in direct contact with the earth. So kapag yung ating installation is nasa in direct contact with the earth, automatic that will be considered as a dry, as a wet location, no? Pwede din sa ano, sa yung mga ano natin, washing area ng ating mga sasakyan. Sa if nasa ilalim dadaan yung ating ano doon, wiring, so that area will be considered as a wet location. Okay? And unprotected location exposed to weather, outdoors. So outdoors is automatic considered to be as wet location. Okay, premises wiring. So these are the wiring in the exterior or the outer part of the building, including the lighting, the power, the control, the signal circuit. So yan yung premises wiring. Nasa loob at labas ng ating building. Pero yung kanyang source is nanggaling sa main na nasa ating building. So that is premises wiring sa ating system. Pag raceway naman, so any enclosed metal channel or non-metallic materials designed to hold wires, cables, or bus bars with additional functions permitted in this code. So yung raceway, any channel or any other material that will hold and protect the wires and bus bars sa ating system, no? So yung mga conduit, a conduit itself is considered a special type of raceway. Bakit? Kasi yung conduit, they are all pipes, no? Electrical pipes, kaya tinawag silang conduit. Meron kasi kita yung raceway like the non-metallic surface raceway, like the underfloor raceways, they do not come in form as a pipe, no? Mga channels lang sila, okay? So yung ang kalang mukha is parang cheat na the cable tray, the bus bar or the busway, so they are considered as raceway, no? Then sealable equipment. So this is an equipment enclosed in a case or cabinet that is provided with a means of sealing or locking so that the live parts cannot be made accessible without opening the enclosure. So yung mismong equipment is sealed, no? So talagang hindi mo siya mabubuksan at hindi mo mahahawakan yung live parts unless you will open the enclosure using a certain lock mechanism. Separately derived system, that is a premises wiring system whose power is derived from other electric source. Example of that is the generator, no? Sa ano kasi sa yeah, the common building is yung hospital may sarili silang system, no? When there is a brownout, yung mismong mga equipment, no, for the use in the ER or the OR will not be interrupted by the sudden, no? Biglang nawawala na ano na tawag doon na supply. Yan. No? Then service, so the conductor and the equipment for delivering electric energy from the serving utility to the wiring system of the premises served. So yung connection, no, galing sa ating ano poste papunta sa ating building or sa ating bahay, that is what we call a service. Yung gamit na conductor doon is what we call as a service cable or service conductor. If our service is in the form of a cable, so ang tawag is service cable. If it is a conductor, so that is a service conductor, so that is from the service point sa transformer to the service disconnecting means, papunta doon sa mismong main na breaker mo. Service drop is, ang service conductor natin is overhead, no? Nakalawit, no? Sa array, yan yung service drop. Yan. Tapos, ang service entrant conductor overhead system is yung service drop natin na yung ating conductor na ginagamit natin as service drop. Yan, no? Habang your service entrance conductor naman, so we say service entrance, so underground system, so yan yung ginagamit natin na conductors as service lateral. So that is between the terminals of the service equipment, yung ating transformer, and the point of connection to the service lateral. Yan. So yan yung ating service entrance conductor, no? From our main breaker papunta sa ating service lateral, so yung connection na yan, that is what we called as service entrance conductor underground system. Yung conductor naman from our service equipment main breaker natin papunta sa ating service drop, that is what we called as overhead system service entrance conductor. Yan. Service equipment, so that is our main breaker, or any other ways to disconnect the system, yung ating bahay, from the source, no, or from the service point. So yung service lateral is just service conductor that is from the post, no, or from the service point to our service entrance conductor, pero ang pagka install sa kanya is nakalibing sa lupa, no, or buried underground. Okay. Then solar photovoltaic system, so the total components of the subsystem that in combination convert solar energy into electrical energy suitable for connection to a utilization load. We say solar photovoltaic system, complete system consisting of the PV panel, the charge controller, the inverters, no, and the battery system, no. Special permission, so the written consent of the authority having jurisdiction. So meaning na meron kang written consent that will give you special permission na pwede mong sabihin na this installation or this construction is following the code. Supplementary overcurrent protective device, so a device intended to provide limited power protection for a specific application and utilization equipment such as luminaires and appliances. No, so the common example for this one is yung overload relay ng ating refrigerator. So it is a supplementary overcurrent device. Meron na tayong overcurrent device sa ating panel board for that ref, no, sa brand circuit breaker. Tapos yung mismong appliances mismo sa kanya is mayroon siyang overcurrent device, no. May sarili siyang overcurrent device, no, to protect the appliances from fault, no, overload or short circuit. Switch, no, different type of switch. So switch bypass isolation, a manually operated device used in conjunction with a transfer switch to provide means of directly connecting load to the conductor to a power source and disconnecting the transfer switch. So when you say switch bypass isolation, so it will bypass the transfer switch and also isolate our system, no, to the source na kung saan siya i-connect. Then we have the general use switch, that is the common switch that you are using, no, kasama yung ating mga three-way, mga single pole, that is a general use switch. General use switch snap, no, so general use snap switch, a form of general use switch constructed so that it can be installed in device boxes or box covers or otherwise used in conjunction with the wiring system recognized by this code, no. So yung mga switch na ilalagay natin sa isang box pa siya, isang assembly, ilalagay natin, no? The example of that is the plug-in breaker. It is considered as a general use snap switch. Then we have switch isolating. So this is a switch that is used to isolate our power from our system from the power, no? So isolating switch. Then motor circuit switch is used for the motors, no, na mayroon siyang rated na horsepower. So capable of interrupting the maximum operating overload, no, of our motor. Transfer switch is used to automatically or non-automatic way to transfer our circuit from one load conductor or another, no? So when you say automatic, ang tawag dito is ATS, automatic transfer switch. Pag sinabing non-automatic, that is MTS, manual transfer switch. Then we have switchboards, no? So switchboards are large single panel frames or assembly of panels in which are mounted on the face, back, or switches, cover card, and other protective device with the unusually instruments. So switchboards are accessible on the rear as well as on the front and are not intended to be installed in cabinets. So switchboard will consist of our protective device buses and the instruments. So ang different niya sa switchgear is yung switchboard is accessible back and front lang. Okay? Voltage nominal. So a nominal value assigned to a circuit or a system for the conveniently designating its voltage class, no? So example 120/240, 480Y/270 volts, or 600 volts. The actual voltage at which a circuit operates can vary from the nominal within a range that permits satisfactory operation of the equipment. So when we are going to design, our nominal voltage is 230 volts, so that is the standard for single phase system. Then voltage to ground. For a grounded circuit, the voltage between the given conductor and that the point of conductor of the circuit that is grounded. For a grounded circuit, the greatest voltage between the given conductor and any other conductor of the circuit. So yung voltage na kukuha mo if you test your live with respect to ground, no? Yan yung voltage to ground, no? Voltage of a circuit, so the greatest root mean square effectively effective difference of potential between any two conductors of the circuit concerned. So yung ating nominal that is constant, 230 volts, but our voltage of a circuit will depend, no, on the voltage drop, no, from our wires, no. Kunyari, ang pumasok sa atin is 230, but if you are going to test our outlet, 225 na lang. So that is the voltage of our branch circuit, 225. So ibig sabihin, meron tayong voltage drop within yung galing sa main papunta doon sa ating outlet. Yan. So that is yung natetest natin doon is the voltage of the circuit. Yung 230, that is the nominal voltage. Thermal protected as applied to motor. So meaning yung ating motor is may nakalagay na thermal protected. So that motor is that one will be written on the nameplate, no? So the motor itself, it means that it is provided with a thermal protector. At ano naman yung terminal protector? So, a terminal protector is a protective device for enclosure under specified test condition, assembly as an integral part of a motor or motor compressor, no? With properly applied, protects against dangerous overheating due to overload and failure to start. So, the thermal protector will protect our motors from overload, no? Or yung kapag hindi sila kapag-start, so nag-iinit, to taas yung current, so the thermal protector will trip, no? The conductor, no, that is supplying current to our motors, no, para hindi masira yung ating motor. Okay, so the different types of duties, no. So first we have the continuous duty. So a certain appliances or a certain load is operating at substantially constant load for indefinite long time. So mataas taas. When you say naman duty intermittent, so that is in alternate intervals. Walang tamang pattern, no? Either ganito, next day, iba na naman. So that is intermittent duty. Periodic duty is may pattern, regular, recurrent. So may pattern siya. Short time duty naman is it is operating at a short time, no? Kunyari nasa ano lang yan, nasa 3 hours below. So that is short time duty. Varying duty, the loads is and the loads and its time interval varies, no? Which may vary in a wide range depending on the type of load. Then dwelling unit. So a dwelling unit is a single unit providing complete independent living facilities for one or more persons, including provision for living, sleeping, cooking, and sanitation. We say living, sleeping, cooking, and sanitation. So yan yung ginagawa natin sa bahay. Our house or our bahay, no, is considered to be as a dwelling unit. Then one family dwelling unit is meaning that dwelling unit is only suitable for one family, no? So two family dwelling unit, so para sa dalawang pamilya. Pag multi-family, so mini, no? Three or more families, no? Circuit breaker. So a device designed to open or close a circuit by non-automatic means and to open the circuit automatically on a predetermined overcurrent without damage to itself when applied within its rating. So yung circuit breaker, pwede natin siyang i-on off manually at nag-trip siya when there is a fault on our system or may overcurrent. So there are many types. So we have adjustable. So adjustable as applied to circuit breaker, we could set no its tripping current and the time kung gaano siya katagal mag-trip. Instantaneous trip is it will have no delay. Kunyari, ngayon nag-occur yung short circuit, automatic trip. So that is instantaneous trip. Inverse time trip is there is an introduced delay. So may delay. Kunyari, short circuit. So after 3 seconds pa siya mag-trip. So that is inverse time. No? So the inverse time circuit breaker, no, is ang ano dito is kapag tumaas yung short circuit current, mas mabilis siyang mag-trip. So yan yung pinaka main characteristic ng inverse time, no? Then non-adjustable, hindi na-adjust yung ating tripping mechanism at hindi rin na-adjust yung ating time na kung gaano siya kabilis mag-trip. So setting, so that when we see setting, yan yung mga value na ating pinapalitan sa circuit breaker, sa adjustable, yung current, time, or both, which is only applicable to the adjustable circuit breaker. Then we have the different types of conductor, no? Yung kanina, exposed, pag concealed naman, so it is rendered inaccessible. Yung exposed kasi nakikita natin, madali nating mahawakan, that is exposed wiring. When we see concealed wiring, so it is inaccessible by the structure or finish of the building. Wires in concealed raceway are considered concealed. So yung mga wires na nasa loob ng ating conduit or raceway, they are considered as concealed. Kahit pa, pwede naman natin silang madaling makuha, no, by pulling the wires through the out of the conduit. A bare conductor, a conductor having no covering or wala talaga siyang insulation. Covered, a conductor encased with a material or of composition or thickness that is recognized by this code as electrical insulation. So yung ating covered na conductor, kunyari ano, meron tayong bare conductor tapos nilagyan natin siya ng cement which is electrically insulated. So that is that conductor now is covered. So hindi siya part ng ano ng ating conductor. So we only apply another material to add insulation to that conductor. Kapag part siya ng ating conductor, common sa ating mga wires, that is now insulated conductor. A conductor encased within a material or composition or thickness that is recognized by this code as electrical insulation. Yan. So, composition and thickness. Yan. Yung ano, yung sa covered composition or thickness. Pag insulated, sinasama yung composition at yung thickness niya, no? So, pag sinabing composition or thickness, no? So, alin dyan sa dalawa? So, hindi, either we consider kung gaano siya kakapal or we consider only the type of material that is covered. If kita consider natin yung composition, kunyari, ano, sa isang wire, ang ating ginamit is TW, tapos yung mismong thickness is we are considering in order to our conductor to be properly insulated. So, that is what we call now as an insulated conductor. Then conduit body, so this is what we call as condolet, no? Yung term natin dito. So this is a separate point on the conduit or tubing system that provide access through a removable covers to the interior system or a junction of two or more connections of the system or at a terminal point of the system. Kapag solderless connector naman or pressure connector, a device that establish connection between two or more conductors or between one or more conductors and a terminal by means of mechanical, no? Mechanical pressure. Yung ating ano crimping lugs, no, yung ating ano kinikrimp, so they are not swordless, no, hindi ba the pressure is what we call swordless. Yung ating kailangan nating magamit ng solder, so that is now our soldered connector or soldered connection. Yung continuous load natin, tulad ng sinabi ko kanina, the load will operate at its maximum current expected to continue 3 hours or more. Yan, so continuous load yan. Okay, no?